Mate, welcome back. Great couple of games.
Yeah, thanks, Nick. It was obviously quite a successful time for us, and yeah, but stoked to be back in Perth.
And World Cup qualified.
Yeah, I think there was a bit of confusion. We qualified last year, June, against Canada in two-leg series. Yeah. So with qualification last year, this was just a sort of June international series for us, so three test matches, and unfortunately went successfully for us, so that's good. Yeah.
So you played Canada before you came back as well?
Yeah, Canada we played on a Saturday past.
But that wasn't a qualifier?
No, that was just for the Can-Am trophy.
Right.
It was successful.
But the big one was Scotland for you.
Yes.
First time you've ever beaten a Tier 1 side.
Yeah. It was a huge game for all of us, and something that we'll definitely cherish for a long time coming.
Yeah. 9 appearances now. I've tried to find the stats. They've been putting the website in slow to load up, but I think it's 9.
Yeah, I've been very lucky to have played my 10th cap on Sunday against Canada. So, any opportunity to represent your home nation is one that you cherish and honour.
When you first came here, I remember we were talking about just this, and you said, oh, it's in the past, or in the distance, a long way off. And it's just, sort of play here and see how it goes. Can you believe now that you could be playing the World Cup next year?
Yeah, look, and it's... It's down to the foundations of the force of laid for me and getting me to a place where I can play international rugby for my country, and I'm so grateful to the force for firstly developing me into the player and the human that I am, but also to them allowing me to go over each time and be able to represent your country at test rugby is something that I'll forever be grateful for to the force.
Been a bit of a journey, isn't it? States, South Africa, Perth, then back to the States.
Yeah, sometimes you don't know which way is home. So, I'm very lucky in having those three places that are now part of me and ingrained within me. And anytime I can go back to either one of them, I know that I feel comfortable there.
And obviously, while you've been away, you've been monitoring results. Obviously, didn't go quite the way you hoped, but still some good efforts in.
Yeah, completely. We quickly forget that we're such an optimistic group that we always put ourselves in a position where we want to go into a game with the mindset to win. And I think those two games definitely gave us an opportunity to look at where we are placed at the moment in terms of our rugby spectrum. People forget we came together in March. And then by May we were playing against a Super Rugby side, in June playing against one of the world's best rugby teams. But I think we take the defeat in our stride and we move on. We see where we can get better and where we continue to improve on. So, like I said, it's another step in the right direction for us, and we look forward to Samoa in a couple of weeks.
I think Tim was saying the other day, excuse me, that four games is really, for most clubs, two trial matches and then two competition games, whereas for you guys it's been straight into it.
Yeah, he's totally right. We're a team in progress. We're constantly learning where we need to improve on, and that's the sign of a really good side, I think, is identifying those things of improvement that need to be in order to get to the next stage, which is to play against those Super Rugby sides to compete and to win. So that's our main goal, and we'll continue to improve on those.
And you also said no more excuses.
Yeah, he's so right. I think we like I said, we're an optimistic team, and that puts us into a place as a side where we don't go into a game trying to hopefully get a result. We go in there with the mindset that if we control the things that we can control, we can come up with a result that's available for us. And he's so right in that no excuses. We if we want to be considered a great side and a competitive side of that, then we need to take matters into our own hands and control the controllables.
Now looking at 2 weeks on for the next game, can you keep the impetus up? Because there's that great, 3 week gap between games, it's pretty unusual.
I think with this group of guys, once they get into the building, they switch on and they know that there's a job at hand. And whether or not that's playing on the weekend or playing for your local club side, when you're here, you're with the force. And then we give the same amount of dedication to our club sides, but I think that's a good sign for us going into a week or going into a week break or a 2 week break, that that when you're in the building you're constantly striving for that following opportunity to represent the force on the sea of blue. So it's it may seem as though there are big breaks, but within those breaks we have the opportunities to, like I said, identify where we can improve on, where the good things and the things that can be better.
And then this, yourself and Rod, two internationals in, what is this, you know, fledgling club? What sort of message does that send?
Yeah, look, that's current, you know, and when you look at it, you know, Bash is also, you know, a Springbok representative. We've got numerous guys that, you know, I believe within the next 4 or 5 months will definitely give, you know, Australian selectors some thoughts about, you know, could this be someone we could take on a spring tour? You know, is this someone that we can see in the future? And that for me is the great thing about what has been going on here, is the opportunity to continue to grow the game in Perth, but also in Australia.
Yep, so just going back to your time in the USA, how good was that experience?
It's always firstly an honour to represent one's country, and such a great experience with a really tight group of guys, much like we've got here at the Force. You know, this group of in the USA has been together now for a couple of years, and it's we're so starting to see some results that are going to be beneficial for the game in the US.
So would this be your first World Cup then?
Oh, yeah.
And what are you looking forward to?
Oh, it's still a long way away. You know, we're about 14 months out, so for us it's just about progressing every time we come together, and if you are selected, to obviously continue to improve and help the side to, you know, get those ranking points and put ourselves in a good position going into World Cup, yeah.
It's a tough group.
Yeah, definitely. It's we wouldn't have it any other way. so we've got some tough sides to compete against, but like I said, it's still a long way away, and we'll just take in our stride with the next series, which is in November.
England, France, Argentina, and Togo. It doesn't come much.
Yeah, you've hit the nail on the head there. So yeah, we'll continue to work on some things and just put ourselves into a position where we can go into the World Cup feeling that, you know, what we put on the field is what we can control. And look to do our best from there.
Just one last one. I know that USA Rugby's been going through a bit of a trauma at the moment, but how's the game accepted over there now? Is it growing in the support?
It's
certainly sevens is massive. So yeah. Is that rubbing off onto the 15s?
Yeah, look, I think a result like the Scotland one certainly made people sit up and, you know, recognise that 15s is as big a game as any. You know, obviously sevens is the Olympic game within the US, and that's something that a lot of kids are attracted to. But the result against Scotland was massive, not only for the rugby community, but the past players and, you know, past management staff and everyone who put blood, sweat, and tears into trying to make USA Rugby what it is. You know, and it was a great way for us to sort of celebrate that idea that, you know, it's not what happened on the field for 80 minutes, it was what happened for years before. And the rugby community in USA is a tight one. It's not as large as the other sports, but it certainly is a community-based sport, quite like here in Perth. So it's growing. The game's big at college levels, it's getting better at high school levels. It's the old saying that, you know, it's the fastest growing team sport in America, and long may it continue to be. And if we results like we did against Russia, Scotland and Canada can help that, then we'll continue to do our best to put rugby on the map in the US.